Greetings. I am New York State Senator Jesse Hamilton, representing the Sunset Park, Park Slope, Gowanus, Prospect Heights, Crown Heights, Flatbush, and beautiful Brownsville. Today I have a very special guest and friend and my nominee for the 2017 New York State Woman of Distinction Award. And her name is Maria Bartolillo. Hello, Maria, how are you doing today?
Okay, Senator, and I have to tell you, I am delighted and very honored to be here today and getting this award.
Thank you so much. And also, you are the director for St. Francis DeSales School for the Deaf.
That's right.
And you're really doing God's work at that school. Been there on several occasions. And the children there, there's such nurturing that goes on in the school. From the gym to the classrooms, the teachers are so attentive to what's going on in your school. But people might not know where your school is located and don't know exactly what the school does in your catchment area. How large is your, do you go from Brooklyn to Queens or Staten Island? How far does your catchment area go?
We do all five boroughs right now. Years ago when I started, 46 years ago, there was a catchment area.
Right.
Where we had Brooklyn and part of Queens.
Right.
Brooklyn, Queens area. And then we had children who were more multiply handicapped than your normal deaf child,
okay,
or your typical deaf child, I should say, not normal, because they're all normal.
Right.
The catchment area spread because other schools did not have the capabilities as far as lifts to bring the children up because there were non-ambulatory children. We started a deaf-blind program. We have deaf autistic children, which other schools do have, but they were overcrowded and we were not.
Right.
We started in that school in 1992.
And for the viewers, where are you located at?
We're on 260 Eastern Parkway in Brooklyn, right across the street from the Brooklyn Museum.
That's right.
And Prospect Park.
That's right.
And that's our campus. So I have to say we're in a beautiful location.
And your student population, what's the size of your school?
Right now we have 74 students, which is low.
Okay.
I totally agree with that. Mm-hmm. And it's the area that's gotten very expensive that children are leaving, and the implants of the new technology.
Right.
You
say implants. Implants for what is that actually?
And an implant is a cochlear implant where they take out the original cochlear that you can't hear.
Right.
And they do put in an artificial cochlea,
okay,
which parents think it's the miracle ear, and it's not.
Okay.
And we teach the children 6 hours a day, but the parents have a lot to do with it. So many children are successful and others are not. So they don't want a signing environment. Parents don't want a signing environment. So they're taking their children and putting them in the mainstream.
When you say signing environment to our viewers, what does that actually mean?
Well, we have total communication. We use total communication.
So sign language
as
you
our
mean with,
approach.
With your hands, right.
Yes, we sign
right
and speak at all times.
Mm-hmm.
Where parents do not want their children to sign. They want them to be normal. And I feel that a lot of parents are in denial, and we try to help them get over that denial. We would never keep children if they were able to go into the mainstream. I'm not keeping children for numbers.
Right.
I don't want numbers.
So if I was a parent and I had a child who has special needs, what grades do you go to, from fifth to high school or?
No, we go from infants
right
all the way to the eighth grade.
Okay. And from eighth grade, from ninth to 12th grade, what were students?
They can go to Lexington School for the Deaf in
okay
Jackson Heights.
Right.
They can go to Murray Bertram.
Oh, really?
High school, yes. They have a program for deaf students.
Mm-hmm.
And Westinghouse
mm-hmm
has a trades program.
Okay.
But the reading level has to be on par. And our students, if you're deaf, you and I learned reading through phonics.
Right.
They can't hear the phonics.
Right.
So their reading level, their highest reading level is maybe a third grade reading level.
Okay.
And that's for the brighter, very bright children. We had one little girl on a sixth grade reading level, and that was very good.
Okay. So how do they, let's say if I'm a person is deaf, they can, you said they their reading level is up to third grade?
Third grade.
So how do they take examinations as far as like civil service exams?
They don't.
Okay.
They are very limited in the jobs.
Okay.
There used to be a lot of printing jobs. And then when computers came along, a lot of the OWL graduates or even their parents lost their jobs because they didn't need them. And they took the deaf because there's a lot of noise. They
right.
didn't hear the noise.
Right.
So it's difficult. And we follow the Common Core and the state standards. And
right.
our children have to take the grade level that they're in. But they're still reading on a third grade level, taking the eighth grade state test.
Okay. Now, is your school private or public?
It's a private, state-supported school.
Okay. And you're designated as a
4201 school, which is a state law.
Right.
And it's under Article 85.
Right.
And the commissioner actually appoints the children to our school, along with the city, which is the Committee on Special Education,
right.
or the Committee on Preschool Education.
Oh, awesome, 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 awesome. So how long have you been at the school as director?
As the director, I've been 6 years as director.
Mm-hmm.
I was 11 years as principal, but altogether I've been there 46 years.
You said you're 46 years old?
No, I'm 46. Yeah, I wish. I wish I was 46 years old.
One day you mentioned to me you had a student who was blind and deaf.
Yes.
That must be so challenging to teach a student who's deaf and blind. I mean, how do you actually communicate to the child?
And that started about 7 years ago.
Right.
We were working with the New York City Collaboration for the Deaf Blind, and they asked if we would open a program.
Mm-hmm.
And we had no training in it, so we needed to get the training. I would not take children if we didn't have training in it. So what you're actually doing is you're signing into their hands.
Mm-hmm.
And you sign the words into their hands, and hopefully after a number of years, they mm-hmm. do get it. And you show them the object. You
right.
need real objects to show them.
Right.
We had a little...
How can they see they're blind. How can they see the object?
No, they feel the object.
They feel it, okay.
They feel the object. And we had a little girl that over the summer, she
right.
became blind. And I went to observe her, and she had so much remembrance of right. when she was sighted. She was able to remember a story and put the figures on the board where they belonged.
Wow.
So she was retelling the story.
So most of the children who are both blind and deaf weren't born with both?
The children that we have now coming in mm-hmm. were born both deaf and blind.
Blind, oh.
And then we have a lot of children with Usher syndrome. And
what's Usher syndrome?
Usher syndrome is that they become blind. It's a congenital disease.
Mm-hmm.
They become blind through their teenage years.
Really?
And they're actually losing their sight. So there is like a lot of training. We have a teacher of the blind
mm-hmm.
working in our school.
Mm-hmm.
We have orientation mobility to get them walking around the area.
Right.
So they know where they're going.
Okay.
So.
And do you have teachers at the school who are also deaf or maybe blind come back to teach? Does that happen?
We have teachers of the deaf that come back, who are deaf that are teaching at the school. We don't have any deaf-blind teachers.
Okay.
But we do have a number of teachers that have been there a while. We have a very dedicated staff, I should say.
Right. Yeah, I was watching the on TV one day, and the mayor had a person doing sign language. And the person seemed so creative and suggestive. And it seemed like the children now who are doing sign, it's like kind of like Vogue, you know, because it's like they're talking a language none of us can understand what they're talking about.
No, it's the expressions.
Right.
You have to, it's a real expressive language.
Okay.
So you're really not acting, but you're moving your body. It's a body language.
Oh, really?
Where you're moving your facial expressions.
Okay.
You can't yell at a child and, you know, be smiling and they know this, stop.
Oh, okay.
You have to show them, stop.
Okay. Now, how long have you been signing?
Since I was at the school, 46 years, I learned at the school.
Now, where did you go to undergrad?
Undergrad, I went to St. Joseph's College, Clinton Hill area.
And so you wanted to be to work with kids who had
disabilities? I always wanted to be a teacher, but I never wanted to go to college, believe it or not. but then I worked for a year, and I said, okay, not for me. So then I went to college, and I got my education degree at St. Joseph's, and then I have a master's in deaf ed.
Okay.
And then I went for leadership.
Wow. So after you got your master's, what did you teach at?
I taught at St. Francis, and I taught upper department, which were children 11 to 15.
So you're really homegrown. You've been there.
This is my life.
Now, I went to a basketball program at the school, and I was very impressed how the kids played, how they communicated with each other. Can you talk more about that, the sports activities at the school?
The basketball game that you went to is a tournament that we have for all of Brooklyn.
We
invite hearing children as well as schools for the deaf.
Okay.
And the first year we had it, the deaf were frightened that the hearing schools were coming, and the hearing schools were frightened that they were playing deaf, and they wouldn't understand them. Mm-hmm. It worked out wonderful. We have a waiting list now for people to join the tournament.
Oh, really?
And what a technician did was every time the ref would blow the whistle, we connected lights to the baskets so they know everyone stops.
Right, right, right. Now, is the population of the school, is it more female than male, or?
It's a combination.
Combination?
Yeah.
Now, if I'm a parent and I want to send my child to your school, if I want to find out more about the school, how would a parent go about doing that?
You could come and visit, or you could look on our website, which is St. Francis de Sales School for the Deaf. And most of the parents that we do get are from the public schools. They do come from the CSE. Mm-hmm. Or parents who just walk in. And I like when they come in. I make it an open door policy.
So you know, parents can just walk off the street?
Yes.
And come to the school?
They can come to the school, visit, visit the classrooms, but they do have to fill out a form for the commissioner to give us permission to evaluate.
The commissioner for the New York State Department?
State.
Okay. It must be expensive, though, sending kids to the school.
Yes, it is. It's expensive.
So to qualify to go there, is it based on income, or can anybody?
No, anyone can go. It's expensive for the state. However, we do have every teacher who has a master's degree, and we specialize in the deafness, or the schools for the blind have a specialization in the blind.
Right.
We are qualified people to teach, and the physically challenged, too.
And your class sizes are how big at the school?
611.
611.
Yes, that means six children, one teacher, one teacher assistant, and then we have really special needs who have deafness with additional multiple disabilities, and that's a 612. And we have, that means six teachers, six students, one teacher, and two teacher assistants.
That's a great ratio.
Yes, it's a wonderful ratio
to have.
Because they need individual attention.
Right. Yeah. Six to one. That's phenomenal. Yes. As far as attention for the kids.
But they do need that.
Do you take field trips with the children? How does that work?
Yes. We love field trips. They love field trips. They go to the theater.
Right.
The theater has free shows that we take them to.
Oh, really?
That's interpreted. And we saw Cinderella. We saw Helen Keller. They really enjoy that. And we actually are going to the African, it's on right on Taft Place, the African Museum.
Awesome, awesome. I just want to say thank you for coming out. Maria, you've been
a pleasure being here.
You've been a great friend, and also you are my 2017 New York State Woman of the Year. I'm Jesse Hamilton, New York State Senator, and we will see you soon. Just loving Brooklyn.